Okay, so first up, a myth that's all about soft landings.
Playing with dolls again, are we?
No. I'm setting up a scenario.
For what?
All right, let me walk you through it. Picture yourself in a hotel room, and you're in mortal danger because there's some guys banging on the door who want to shoot you. Now, you can't obviously leave through the normal means like the door. You've got to leave by jumping off your balcony. Unfortunately, your balcony, it's 35 feet above the ground. Fortunately, however, there's a swimming pool below you. Unfortunately, that swimming pool's only 4.5 feet deep.
That could get ugly.
Very ugly. This comes from the show Burn Notice, and what our hero is explaining to the audience as he throws a mattress out the window and into the pool, and then he jumps into the mattress to safety.
So the myth is that if you need to jump into a shallow pool from a height, you should throw a mattress down there first.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
According to this Burn Notice myth, there's no way you could leap and live after a 35-foot drop into shallow water. However, breaking your fall with a mattress could supposedly save your butt. So would a crash landing really leave you with more of a spring in your step than a splash landing?
So how do you want to test this?
Well, clearly the main thing here is to test what it's like to jump onto a mattress in a pool, but we need to compare that to what it would be like just jumping into the pool as well.
Yeah, indeed. And we're going to need a pool that's exactly 4.5 feet deep.
Well, let's get a crane and some dummies and attach some sensors to them and drop them off, see what happens.
That's perfect. Let's do it.
So it's straight to the shallow end at DeFremery Pool in Oakland.
That's a nice pool.
It ought to work.
Let's see if we can get Buster hurt.
Okay.
Where they'll hoist Buster up for this three-story story.
Turns out one of the most difficult parts of this shoot is just getting the gradle into the pool area. It's a bit of a tight squeeze. This whole story comes down to, if you have 35 feet to jump, and you've got a pool below you that's only 4.5 feet deep, is it better to jump into the regular pool or onto a mattress floating in that pool? With all the drops that Buster's gonna do, we're gonna wanna make sure we know how hard he's dropping, and that's where this comes into play. This is an accelerometer, and just like a crash test dummy, I'm going to install this in Buster's chest to let us know how many G's he pulls on each of the surfaces we're dropping him on.
With an accelerometer heart to track his impact.
Let's close him up.
The PVC man is ready for the drop.
Only in MythBusters is someone transferred on a stretcher to be dropped off a building.
However, first he needs to adopt the Burn Notice position.
Now in the show, our character states that properly distributing your weight, i.e. landing butt first onto a mattress on the water, is the safest way to jump into the pool.
So Buster will jump butt first. But first up, Buster will take the plunge without a mattress. So what kind of damage will that drop do?
Here we go, Buster. Time to jump into the pool.
Okay, dropping Buster into the water from 35 feet in 3, 2, 1. Go!
That was just as much fun as it seemed like.
Buster took the fall, and his backside took a whack from both the water and the bottom of the pool. But what does the data say?
So we dropped our dummy 35 feet straight into the water, and we saw an initial impact of 50 Gs. Followed by an impact along the bottom of the pool of 29 Gs. Now, 50 Gs is our threshold for potential death. One way or another, you're not walking away from an impact like that.
Yep, there's no walking away from that. But how will it compare with the myth? Can the average mattress...
For our mattress test, we've chosen a standard inner spring mattress. That's this one right here.
Really make a fatal flop survivable.
Perfect.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go! Nice!
X marks the spot. Buster hit with an audible impact. But did the mattress cushion his tush?
Buster's drop was perfect. And although he might not look like it, according to our accelerometer data, he is a freaking mess. He pulled 86 Gs hitting that mattress, roughly equivalent to a severe car accident. And that was supposed to be the safe jump. It's not looking very good for this story.
It's not looking good, because that's a more damaging impact than onto water alone. However...
Well, I love our accelerometer data from all these drops, but I can't help feeling like they're not giving us the full picture. I'd love in some way to be able to see what kind of injuries Buster might take from that kind of fall.
I know what you mean. And I might have just the thing. Hey, Adam, check this out.
Oh!
Yep, you may remember this disturbing face from the Halloween special.
Are you ready for the horror?
But its role as John Doe hid the Sindaver's real purpose.
To the window!
As an ultra-realistic human analog.
These are surgical training dummies. They're made muscle by muscle, and they're actually sutured in place.
Oh my God. I dare say that it's absolutely beautiful. This is medically accurate?
It is. It's made of a polymer. It's water-based. And everything is as realistic as modern technology can make it.
And its anatomy isn't the only thing that's realistic.
I wish you were here, because it's beautiful and it smells kind of bad, which you'd expect.
But before the Sindaver can take the plunge, Jamie needs to give it a skin. And this shrink wrapping also doubles as waterproofing.
Ready for market.
So with the Sindaver skinned up, it's time to drop it off at the pool.
You feeling ready, buddy?
One of the nice things about using this particular type of dummy is that with the help of a portable X-ray machine like this device over here, we can actually figure out what happened internally to the dummy without performing the equivalent of an autopsy.
So after a checkup to make sure everything is where it should be.
You can see that the ribs come across, they're all intact. You can see all the cervical vertebra.
It's time to strap up the Sinbuster for its first fall into 4.5 feet of water.
Sindaver into the pool from 35 feet in 3, 2, 1, go.
A perfect hit.
It's bottoms up for the new buster. But what kind of damage did that drop do? Well, to find out, it's fished out for a closer examination by both the X-ray and an expert.
Now that we've dropped our dummy, we would really like to get an expert opinion on exactly how much damage they've sustained. And we'd like an expert that deals with this kind of injury every single day, and that's called an orthopedic surgeon. We found one named Dr. Noah Weiss. Dr. Weiss, are you willing to give us a free consult on Buster's injuries?
Sure, I'd be happy to.
Let's go take a look.
We can see over here is there's actually been a separation between the lumbar spine and the sacrum. This is a very severe injury that would most certainly result in major spinal cord damage.
Wow, so our dummy's paralyzed.
It's paralyzed.
So our Sindaver, after being dropped into the swimming pool without a mattress in its way, has sustained some very serious damage, a shattered pelvis and a paralyzing spine injury. And if it seems like I'm smiling, I'm only happy that we got some significant results from this dummy. Now, we're gonna drop one into a mattress.
In their previous test with the original Buster, the G-load of the drop onto a mattress was higher. But will that mean that Sinbuster 2 sustains more injury by making a bed and leaping into it?
Ready, Adam?
Ready!
3, 2, 1, go!
Perfect hit!
Buster hit the crash pad, and its butt took the brunt. So it's over to Dr. Weiss to find out if the Sinbuster's rear is in the clear.
On physical examination, what's immediately apparent is the pelvis is far more unstable compared to the previous Sindaver.
Really?
Yeah, this is completely disrupted.
Wow.
And that's not all. As the X-rays reveal, the mattress jumper sustained far more damage all over.
In addition to a similar injury where he basically blew apart his pelvis, this one also appears to have two injuries to his spine, one in the lumbar spine or low back and one in the mid back or thoracic spine. He dislocated his knee, he dislocated his elbow, and the injury to the pelvis was much worse than in the first Sindaver.
So the mattress was far worse than falling into water.
I think both jumps were a problem, but it definitely appears to be much worse landing on the mattress in the water.
So he's even more dead?
He would be even more dead than the first one.
Is that a medical term?
It is now.
Okay. tested this thing 6 ways to Sunday, actually 4 ways and on weekdays, but we have found that yes, jumping from 35 feet is bad into water, but in the mattress, it's like twice as bad. This is a counterintuitive result, which for us is totally awesome.
Yep, both Buster and Sinbuster tell the same story. Despite what you'd expect, a mattress doesn't cushion a splash landing. It only makes it worse.
So where would you say this myth stands?
You know, it's on the tip of my tongue, but I can't quite, what is it, not right,
not...
Not
truthful.
Ill-conceived.
Ill-conceived, improper, let's say just wrong.
Okay, it's wrong.
It's wrong.